Construction, reconstruction, and renovations are familiar words to those familiar with the University of Iowa campus. In 2009, the University of Iowa declared a LEED standard as they continue to build and renovate the campus in an effort to be more sustainable. LEED stands for Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design, and it is an internationally recognized standard developed by the United States Green Building Council. Already, the university's new facilities are exceeding expectations and reaping their rewards.
Well, our first LEED building was the Beckwith Boathouse, which is a beautiful building located directly on the Iowa River. But it was built to be flood resilient. We know that the Iowa River waters will rise and will fall at times, and so that building needed to be built to withstand inundation at times.
The Beckwith Boathouse was completed in 2009 and has many features that allow it to stand strong before the Iowa River, but the university did not stop there. Though administrators promised a silver standard, four university buildings have already received LEED Gold awards, and most recently, the university truly shined in receiving a LEED Platinum award for the new information technology facility.
There are only a handful of Platinum information technology centers in the world, and we're lucky to have one of them here on our campus, so we're really proud of that.
Attaining LEED Platinum status for an information technology building is no small feat. This building is larger than the football field and contains rows of batteries, endless computer servers, and monstrously large industrial equipment. The project took nearly 7 years and $30 million to complete, but the investment could really pay off.
I believe that it costs more to build energy efficiently, but the kicker is that every single minute that this place is running, we're saving money that we would have otherwise been spending had we not made that expenditure. So over a 10, 20 year period, who knows what the energy savings is gonna be.
Among the factors that make the building environmentally friendly, some of the smallest tricks have the best outcomes.
You see that we have empty space here, and so what would go here is another bank of batteries as we have the need for it, but not before. A little bit of energy savings there, and every little bit helps.
In leaving empty space, the building is always ready for expansion without the additional cost of more construction. Other tricks include keeping the lights turned off, conserving rainwater, and using an excellent filtration system that will keep the air around the building clean too. Other universities will see what we're doing and try to imitate our practices.
You know, they'll probably be forced to do it, and I think one of the cool things about the University of Iowa is that although we weren't forced to do it, we did it because it's the right thing to do. And it cost more to do that, but I think we have to be leaders in that way.
After this inspiring accomplishment, the university has no plans to stop. While the Biomedical Research Center is still in construction and on its way to becoming another LEED certified building, the College of Public Health was completed in 2011 and its certification is in the works.
This is the beautiful new College of Public Health. You can see around here the beautiful use of locally available materials like limestone and woods. And if you notice, the glass is on the east side of the building, so it takes advantage of early morning light and floods the entire atrium here with light. And by the time that the sun moves to the south, it's against a brick wall or a stone wall. And so that reduces the need for additional air conditioning.
Most of what goes into keeping our buildings energy efficient are creative ways of using natural resources, conserving those resources, and investing a little extra now to see great payoff in the future.
I mean, we're not walking away from this LEED designation and building so sustainably. It just makes sense. It really does.